A clip of Bernie on Face the Nation this weekend.
Do you worry when you talk about the corporate media that you are targeting journalists when you say that?
No. Donald Trump talks about fake news, and that's simply to deflect attention from the fact that he's a pathological liar. My experience one-on-one with media, they work hard. They very rarely am I misquoted. But what I am talking about, Margaret, is that corporate media limits the kind of debate that we have in this country. Mm-hmm. You tell me, you know more about it than I do. How often do we talk about income and wealth inequality?
We're talking about right now, Senator.
Yeah, but how often? Not everybody is Bernie Sanders on your show. How often do you talk about concentration of ownership? How often do you talk about the fact that we are the only major country on earth not to guarantee health care at all, mm-hmm. and yet we spend twice as much money? How often do you talk about that if somebody has a baby in Finland, they're getting 9 months off or 10 months off paid family leave?
I will talk to you about paid leave for families any day of the week. They also have like a 56% tax rate in Finland, though. It's a very different system. But
good, but let's talk about it. What do they get for that? They get free health care, right?
Mm-hmm.
Free higher education. That's the kind, that's exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
That's the debate I want, and that's the debate we really don't have on the corporate media.
Play that again. Let me just play the beginning of that clip.
Sure.
She goes,
Do you worry when you talk about the corporate media that you are targeting journalists when you say that?
No.
Okay. What she's doing here is suggesting that talking about the corporate media and critiquing the corporate media is targeting journalists, like putting them at risk. And she's trying to link him to Donald Trump because Donald Trump, of course, was very disrespectful towards the media. But like they always do, they like to pretend that two guys who tap into people's anger, one of them says, I feel your pain, blame Mexicans and Muslims. The other one says, mm-hmm. I feel your pain, don't blame Mexicans and Muslims, blame corporate greed, that those two guys are the same, as if they're putting the same people at risk.
Right.
And people can be critical of Bernie as much as they want. I also think that you can be critical of him, acknowledge when he's making good points. I think what he said about Israel was great. Mm-hmm. I don't like where he is on Ukraine. As you know, anyone who watches the show knows that I don't agree with him on that issue. But that to me was he was very gracious about it. I was very angry. I'd mm-hmm. be very angry if she had said that to me because it's so stupid. But he handled it great. He was like, look, how often do you talk about, living wage?
And then when she said, we're talking about it right now, he was so quick to be like, well, not everyone is. That was so good.
Yeah.
The one thing that if I'm just, nitpicking, because I would not be that polite, was I think that he also said something like, to his knowledge, they don't often, misquote or something to that effect. I mean, I guess I would have to go back and maybe double check that. But intuitively, I'm just kind of like, do they, I don't know.
Right. No.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, but I understand, though, in his position in that moment, you have to pick your battles and, you have to play that game, which is why, he's on the inside doing what he can do. We have the ability to speak a lot more freely, exactly how we would want. And yeah, but that was pretty awesome. And so the other clip that I wanted to share was, I don't know if this occurred before or after that, but apparently a young lady and what looks to be maybe a, kind of a concierge person at a hotel maybe, were doing a TikTok. It looks to be like in Midtown New York.
Mm-hmm.
And then this happened.
He begged me to stay. Hey, I'm not staying, I just wanna play. In the party, you just wanna rock.
So Bernie.
Oh, he's so great.
Yeah.
But I agree. And I think that, it's valid criticism. There is valid criticism to be had, but I don't know. If I had my way, I would want, to be just this binary black and white thing where there's no nuance and no playing the game when necessary. But I also acknowledge that that's kind of a reality. And at least to me, I think that I'm hard pressed to find anyone else currently in Congress that is closer to where I would wish that everyone would be at than someone like him.
Right.
Even if, like you said, there are issues we may not necessarily agree with completely.
Right. Right. He's still amazing on certain issues.
And I just think, like, the looking at the broader scope of things, I don't think that we probably don't fully appreciate how important some of these things are in terms of, at the bare minimum, expanding what the way he put it, expanding the boundaries of acceptable conversation. Like, I don't know, was it in the 2016 or 2020 primaries where he was on the debate stage? And as far as I'm aware, he's literally like the first person ever to like call out Israel or acknowledge Palestinians' right to exist on the national stage in that way. Like, that's a big deal.
Yep.
So anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah. But that's can I just play that one more time?
Yeah, of course.
Okay. He begged me to stay. Babe, I'm not staying. I just want to play. In the party, you just want to rock. I wonder what they're thinking. Like, if you were like doing that, like, fun, and you'd look around and Bernie's like right behind you. Oh, man.
Right.
I don't know. But anyway.
So hilarious.
Yeah. Yeah. Did you see the, I forget who wrote it, but someone did a interview with him recently where they sat down in a restaurant and it was like, he asked, I don't know, maybe they mentioned Valentine's Day and Bernie asked them, when is Valentine's Day? And they said, literally,
Bridget Reed. Yeah, Bridget Reed at New York Magazine.
Like, as we are speaking,
happening.
Is
it this weekend? It's this weekend? Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
He's just worried about giving everybody health care. You know, he doesn't have time to remember when those things happen.